They do claim the tie under. Venomance are trying to fall back through the middle lane too. Mystic State bouncing around. A lot of damage. Vermilion staying on top too. They can't keep it going. They won't kill the tier 3 tower. Successful defense by Nirvana MY.
Having a look at the players level right now, well, it's successful defense, but they lost quite a lot of players. That means a lot of gold loss. Looking at what the Necrolite is going to get now. Probably going to see what items he's going to get. So Medusa still with the same items at the moment. Arcane really needs to get a dagger in order to be more useful during engagement. At the top lane, Fionn is just farming. He has a Hex and he has a Eel.
Yeah, he had that in that last battle too. You know, that's why there were so many chickens rolling themselves around. And you really got to give everything to Furion right now. He's been one of the best players we've seen so far on the map today. He, of course, next to HY, but SS. He has got those yields absolutely perfect every single time. The Gwinsu, the Hexes that were going up before then too, shut down XY when he was trying to actually stay alive in the bottom there. Without that four staff, he would have actually gone down as well. Mid lane defense though, just look how much pressure is being applied. It forces Visage, it forces VS to defend it, using those gargoyles to slow down the wave too. They can't let that lane go unchecked, because if they do, the range racks will go down, and then you'll see the tier 4 towers under siege.
So many disables on the Sentinels side. How do you think the Scourge are going to keep up?
At the moment, just basically through ganking. Catch them out, try and split them up as much as you possibly can. It's causing them buybacks at the moment, because on the same front, the Sentinel haven't been buying back that much. It's probably about an equal in the end. But you still have a little counter warning coming out from Sven. Gotta love it, just trying to actually control the different areas too. Visage trying to push out this middle lane too. But as far as the group engagements actually go, the best thing that Nirvana MY can do, defend on the tier 3 towers, try and keep the pressure on, try and chain off those familiars too, get them to drop them down, keep the continuous stuns going, and slow down the approach here. It's really, really hard to kill the entire wave, because it just gets so much bigger and bigger, because obviously Furion creating those trends, creating those force of nature to push through this bottom lane. They're going to come in and just start attacking the tower. TP goes on top of it. Visage is attacking from the sideline. Glimpf fires off. Doozer is the one to TP in now. The Glimpf is fired off. Now is the time to push. They can attack the tower. Even Furion's doing it from down on the bottom of the ramp there. Miss is also coming off, so he doesn't actually get any damage off the back of the tower. But waiting to go through. Furion actually hugging Tidehunter for just a moment there, deciding, hang on, I need support before I go in for this one. 25 for 29. Still five heroes from SB, just showing themselves on the bottom lane, just showing that the Nirvana MY really has to keep everyone there, but they're buying time, because look at the mid now too. The trends are going through, they're attacking the range racks, now they're going to go, VS swap goes out, that rider goes through, Venomancer already goes off, Tidehunter can't get his off, he's still getting stunned, Lion trying to retreat on the top lane, Batrider trying to bring him down, doesn't actually get it on the way through, they're all falling back right now, mid is still getting racks completely while this is happening, tier 3 tower goes down, Tidehunter's about to die now, they're trying to bring him down, they do bring down the Doozer, two down for other side. Batrider trying to escape. The familiars are holding him in place right now, as well as XT being held in place by the trees. Sven trying to retreat in the bottom lane. The sting goes off. Net's in trouble. Net goes down. Oh. Deuce's back. Has brought back. They're to try and defend. That mid's being pushed through. Look at those super size speed creeps pushing through the mid lanes there. And there's those gargles just desperately trying to stop the push through. And it looks like Fury now, she managed to actually catch out one of the heroes as well, just down near the Asian creeps.
Well, that was exactly what Sabo Bawa, and they wanted to, make them all stand here and defend at the bottom lane. And then in the middle lane, the creeps are already pushing in, managed to take down the Rex, push all the way to the level 4 tower of the Scourge team. Scourge really, really needs to find a perfect engagement. They're not really doing well in engagement right now. There's very little teamwork.
Mm-hmm. 29-31.
There seems to be like some miscommunication in engagement.
Yeah, it's just getting a little bit split up right now. Of course, it's not over. They have lost their mid racks. They haven't lost their bottom one, so it's still only one racks down. That is very easy to come back from, especially with the power they've got running out of their lineup right now. Just be careful when they do get picked off there. Batrider was like literally just picking people pieces. That lasso able to split them up there, and even when they're in the big group, then the Venomancer ulti pops off too. Yamatar has just been taken out of the mix. They take out the support heroes, allowing them to really focus on Yamatar too, to bring him down. He does actually have his Lincolns as well as his Yasha completed too. So wants to try and get that Mantra up as fast as possible. The only down. So he's had to buy it back. I think maybe 3-4 times, Kelly. I think we've seen Yamatar buy back.
Yeah, but he needs to, because otherwise his team can't really do any damage without him. He does have a fair amount of money right now, just waiting for him to get his item. They do want the bottom Rexes so bad. So, the Rasta and the Vino is going to push. I mean, the Plague Ward is so painful.
It's like no matter where you go, you're going to find one.
Yeah, well, we're probably going to see a push at the bottom lane soon, but currently the Furion is at the top lane. maybe they're going to do a 4-1 push. You do see, you know, the creeps are all going to push out at the top lane. Bottom lane, the creeps are pretty near too. Here comes the Visage. He's going to try. He already has a hood, so he will have a pipe soon. Waiting for a comeback from Nirvana NY. We have seen it a lot of time before in this tournament.
Yeah, it is a little good. It's easy to come back from. I say easy. You're going up against SB right now. Things aren't always as easy as it seems. But there is a way to actually push it out. We do actually have that push coming towards that tier one tower with Medusa leading the charge at the moment. No one else actually there for the middle lane charge. And that tier one tower really hasn't actually gone down yet, but it's trying to get a little bit of momentum behind that at the moment. If they can actually keep it up, Rass is on the bottom lane. Fury and TP is going to come in as well. Here he comes. Tyon's hanging in the mix too. Venomous is going to show himself down there on the bottom lane as well. So four heroes for the Sentinel side for SB, ready to push down on this untowered defended Rax on the bottom lane. Will the defense for Nirvana NY hold this time? That is going to be the question. There's no glyph. It should still be on cooldown. Furion comes in a little bit closer. We're seeing him going for the trees. Dusa just being baited a little bit more. Sticky Napalm going on top of him, just slowing him down a little bit further. Visage comes out, still trying to harass that Furion back then. They don't want him actually hanging around as long as he can in this battle. He'll just keep on popping off those sheep sticks. He'll keep on going for the Yules as well. The cooldown is just so low on the Yules as well as the sheep. 30 and 35 now. The Plague Ward's also setting up here. Splash goes off on the Visage. Tyon thinks he might go. Ravage should be up. Look for it to go. They're in. Wards go down. Tyon, Ravage goes up. He manages to catch four. Batrider from the side. Wants to bring down line. The VS swap base actually cancel that one out now. They've all managed to put himself up. Tyon's in trouble. He will go down. There's the first one actually go down. The Yules have already set the Deucer up in the air. Running themselves back out. They need more trips. They need to actually hold this lane as long as they can. Rasa's still doing what he actually can. Stunned on the side now. Defense standing on the Batrider.
Finger goes onto the Venomancer from the Lion. They're gonna try to take it now. Down goes the Medusa. Is he gonna go now? She gets taken by the one. Four stuff there onto the Batrider.
Oh, what a play there by SB. Still moving through. Those wards are still there. Furion doesn't want to finish just yet. TP support is coming in. There's a lot of trends. Merely racks us down. They've got what they wanted. Sven's going to try and clear this up right now, as well as Lion, Visage, and Dusa. More buybacks. That is the fifth buyback we've seen from Yamatar so far. HY looking for something. He literally just blinked out. It's like, give me a kill. Can't get it. Has to go back. Tier 4 towers. Currently being sieged as well.
Level 3 tower taken out at the top lane by the Furion. He is going to back soon. He doesn't care. He's going to try to take on the creep. He's forced he just forced off himself out.
Seriously, that's like a hop, skip, and a jump straight back out of the base after taking out the tier 3 tower. All tier 3 towers are down. All racks are exposed. They're gone in the mid for the Scourge for the Nirvana NY side. They've lost their melee on the bottom, and their top melee is down at half HP as well. They're being pressured everywhere.
I have to be really fair though, the Furion is playing really well. She knows like when to TP and he knows what to do to engagement, who to trap. Look at the amount of Furion he has, look at the items he has. He has Hex, he has Eel, he has the Force stuff.
Yeah, SS is definitely going to be labeled as the MVP for this match. He is just so damn good for where he needs to be at the right times. Keeping the pressure on. This is just the power of Furion. Able to move himself around too. He's still farming up while all this is happening too. Obviously, those trends, so many of them. Able to get those last hits down there. Lion blinks off. They won't ever go. He pushes himself down. He tried to actually go and anticipate the stun. Finger goes off. He's actually managed to chicken himself right now. On Yules' XY as well. He will have that blink. He can go again. Force push staff. Will he get himself out? Where is he? He finds him in the trees. That's the experience showing out right there from HY.
You know, Lion forced out the Furion towards him. It was so funny.
How awesome was Prophet though? He thought he could predict the impale, but avoid the impale, that wouldn't have happened. He would have got himself very, very clearly out there and tried to predict it there. SS trying to be too smart, but HY outsmarting him still on top of that one. Prophet though, we saw him once again buying back, wants to keep this pressure on. There is no way they want to let up on Nirvana NY. Don't give them room to breathe. Keep that mid pushing in. Look at this bottom even pushing in right now. Deuce is doing whatever she can to actually do that, and even then need support from Lion and VS to actually hold it off.
She's like, I don't care, I got money, you kill me, I'm gonna buy out straight away. 1.2k is nothing to me. Well, the Furion is gonna be really aggressive right now. I would even dare to say Furion is a star player for this match.
Oh, definitely, absolutely definitely. In we go, trees go up, he creates more, they go in, the pipe pops off right now, it will keep him alive. Venomancer ulti, probably not the best time to pop that one off. In we go, Batrider pulling the Medusa back, the wards are gone down, the trees are holding Sven out of the mix too. Medusa pops up the Manta, Ravage kills every single illusion. Great swap there by VES, it's not enough though, he will actually die as well. The dive is coming from SB, the drain coming from HY, blinks himself back into it. The GG call is coming out from Nirvana NY. They know it's over. And Stars Bobber take fifth place here at SMM 2010. Sixth place going to Nirvana MY as well, working very, very hard to go through all the group stages to get themselves to this moment. It was a big, big game, and of course they should be applauded for their efforts as well.
GG goes over there in the game. Great game. SMM still really exciting. Gonna have grand we're gonna have lower brackets finals soon and grand finals in a while. So stay with us.
That we definitely will. Don't go anywhere, people on the live stream. People who are here live in Malaysia for the SMM 2010. There are more matches coming up on the main stage. We are working our way to the grand final. The question is, who will verse eHome? Who will it be? We will find out soon. Look forward to your company.